Evony Lambito Alisa, and now we will discuss about the 10 steps in order to build resilience. Okay, paano nyo ma-overcome yung mga problems, no? And it actually starts during childhood years. Dapat yung mga parents, you guide the child to solve problem, not solve the problem for them, okay? So, very important talaga na alam nila na merong problema sa buhay at hindi ito natatapos. Okay, so relaxation skills. So, it's very important to have good enough sleep, like 6 to 8 hours a day. Meditation. So, I have a video about meditation. So, please watch that. Self-care is very important. And, of course, if you're thinking about relaxation, it's more of your self-care as well because you take care of yourself. So, exercise like morning walk with sun exposure before 9 a.m. It's very important to relax. So, next is thought record. So, what is thought record? We actually write down the thoughts we have, especially when there is overwhelming emotion. So, you have to be aware of your thoughts. And it's really helpful because you cannot correct something that you're not aware of. Okay, positive thinking. Okay, positive thinking, it's more of the actively controlling your thoughts in to make it positive. Okay, they're what we call automatic negative thoughts, and it's really detrimental to our mental health, and we really have to correct that. Next one is to change mindset on bad events. Okay, find positive sides of negative situations. So being optimistic. Okay, so kailangan alam natin na yes, may problem, but there will always be a solution for that. And you have friends, you have family, no? Don't be so critical about problems. So change your mindset niyo about bad events, because it's always about 5% that really what's happening or the events in our lives, and it's 95% our response. Failing forward, meaning we learn from our past failures. It doesn't mean na failing forward na mag-fail ka na mag-fail or repeat yung mga mistakes mo. It means learning from your experience and then making yourself a better person. Okay, improve yourself to avoid committing the same mistakes over and over again. Okay, okay, we really have to improve ourselves. Kasi nauulit lang nauulit yung problem if hindi natin hindi tayo self-aware. Okay, be logical and find solutions. There is a saying that you must not focus on the problem. Yung problem, nandyan yan. Pero yung kailangan natin i-focus is kung paano masolusyonan. What are the options? What are the solutions? So, it is always about how we respond, okay? So, be positive. Always be positive, no? And there are times naman na pag nadadown ka, isipin mo na lang, there will be time na masosolve mo yung problem. Okay, this will pass. Okay, there is no permanent thing in the world except change. Okay, everything is temporary, so this will pass. Okay, yung problem na to, magpapas lang yan. Hindi yan permanent. Okay, goal setting, of course, we have to have daily goal setting according to our values para hindi tayo parang dinadrag, no? Na pinipili tayong gumawa ng something na hindi tayo happy. Okay, so goals must be will actually help you if it's about your values as well or in accordance to your values. Okay, improve self-esteem. Build your confidence to overcome the challenges in your life. You can rely to yourself, okay? So, improve yung self-esteem nyo. Kasi, pag increase yung self-esteem natin, yung feeling natin, yung confident tayo na masasolve yung mga problems natin. Okay? So, we have to be self-aware then in order to build our self-esteem and be confident. Okay? Build happy and stronger relationship. Of course, it's very healthy to have a good relationship. And it's one of the important things that we must have in order to build our resilience. Build a happy, stronger relationship. Kahit na konti lang yung friends mo, pero very reliable sila and trustworthy sila, and hindi sila nawawala pag may problem ka, then you can rely on them, okay? Build a good, strong relationship as well with your family, okay? So meron nga yung kasabihan na if you really want to succeed in life, have a very healthy, committed relationship with your partner. If you have a husband or a wife or a girlfriend o boyfriend, magiging successful ka if reliable siya, okay? Yung healthy yung relationship niyo. Okay, support system is very important in building resilience, okay? Kasi sila yung mga tao na nandyan, yung mga person that you can rely on. So, good support system is also important. Okay, so be flexible. Again, there are things you cannot change and there are a lot of things you cannot control. So, be flexible. Okay, tanggapin yung mga bagay na hindi na talaga mababago. Okay, pareho ng family nyo. Hindi nyo mabago yung family nyo. Hindi nyo mabago yung kung ano yung itsura nyo. Okay, pwede ma-improve pero hindi nyo mababago. Yung pwede nyo mabago, yung like for example, emotional quotient nyo, pwede nyo ma-improve. Okay, so for those who want to build your resilience, it's so important to have good support system. And kung gusto niyo yung tulong, just chat, okay? Pwede ko kayong tulungan. So take care, God bless, thank you for watching. Okay, salamat.